Hello everyone, I've been messing around with Blender to make some 3D printable pieces and wanted to have some textures. Now, Blender does have an excellent sculpting tool, but I'm lazy, so I looked for an easier way to do it, and in this video I'm going to show you what I found. I'm Carl, and this is Carl Makes Stuff. Let's start by setting up the model. I'm going to start by adding a cube and flattening it a bit. Next, we're going to apply the transformation. Don't forget to do this, it is very important. A cube does not have enough geometry for what we want to do, so next we're going to tab into edit mode and press Ctrl R to loop cut. Type 10 to cut the cube into 10 pieces, click and press Enter. Then repeat this on the other axis. Now we have a nice grid to work with. I only want to have the top face textured, so I deselect everything. Press 3 to go into face select mode, and just select the top faces. At this point we can go to the object data properties, that's this green triangle, and add a vertex group. I call the displacement to keep things clear, but the name is not important. We need all the geometry we can get, so let's step out of edit mode and add a subdivision modifier. I switched it to simple to preserve the edges, but you could also use creases if you like. Next, we're going to bump the viewport and render levels up to 3. That's the setup done, so let's add in our displacement map. But first, let's talk about what that is. What we're looking at here is a displacement map. The idea is that the brightness of any point on this image shows you how high that point is. So the lighter points are more elevated, and the darker points are more recessed. The thing that you have to remember here is that you're not looking at light and shadow, which is what an ordinary picture would be showing you. What this map is showing you is depth. There are a number of ways you can make them. You can draw them in Photoshop or GIMP, or if you're just making something for your personal use, you can find plenty on the internet. I'll leave a link to the site where I got this one from in the description, but now let's get back to the model. To add the displacement map, we're going to add a displace modifier to our cube. And you can see right away that it's gone weird. Don't panic, this will happen a lot till we finish setting it up. Go to the box which says new and click it. This will mess it up in a new and interesting way. Now click the box at the end of the row. The reason the model is messed up is that the texture is currently all black, so everything is getting recessed. No worries, click open to load your map and bam, instant spiky monstrosity. Let's get this into shape. Go back to the modifiers tab and turn the strength down to 0.1 and mid-level to 0. The strength controls how high the maximum elevation is, and the mid-level is an offset for the midpoint. So by setting it to 0, the deepest points are now recessed into the cube. Now the displacement map is applied everywhere, which is not what we want. So we're going to add the vertex group we created earlier. There are still a few artifacts around the edges, but we can get rid of them with a Boolean modifier if we want to. The texture still looks a bit choppy. If this happens, bump up the subdivisions so the displacement has even more geometry to work with. And you have a texture piece which you can now print. There's one more trick you can pull with this. If you set the strength to negative 0.1, the map will be inverted, so you get a negative of the texture instead. This is great if you want to make a stamp or a mold. You can also apply this to a cylinder to make yourself a roller. And that's it for this video. I hope you got something useful out of it. Have fun, stay safe, and see you around.